lost at sea. As years went by, many ships were lost in the Bermuda Triangle. In 1880, a huge ship called the Atlanta sailed from Bermuda towards England. On board were 290 men, officers, and young cadets. The ship never reached England. None of the men were ever seen again. The very next year, an even stranger thing happened. A ship called Ellen Austin was sailing in the Atlantic north of Sargasso Sea. All of a sudden, someone on board spotted a derelict, a ghost ship. Derelict is a word for ships that are found drifting upright on the ocean with no one on board. What happened? Did it fall under a spell of some unknown force in that part of the ocean? The captain of Ellen Austin watched the ghost ship drifting for 2 days. He wanted to make sure it was really abandoned. He didn't want to walk into a trap set by pirates. Finally, he decided it was safe. He sent some of his own men in a small rowboat to check out the drifting ship. When they boarded the ghost ship, they found the ship's log was missing and the name had been removed from the boat, the front of the ship. Other than that, though it was in a good condition, fully stocked with food. So the captain ordered his men to sail the abandoned ship back to New York, staying close to the Ellen Austin along the way. In those days, if someone found an abandoned ship, there was a reward money for bringing it back to the nearest port. But Ellen Austin and the ghost ship got separated by bad weather, fog, and strong winds. A few days later, the captain finally spotted the derelict again, but it was drifting crazily and there was no men on board. His own men, second crew, had vanished completely. As time went by, more unexplained things occurred in or near Bermuda Triangle. In 1909, one of the world's greatest sailors was a man named Joshua Solcom. He was famous for being the first man to sail alone all the way around the world. On his journeys, he had survived huge storms, attacks by pirates, and worst. But he disappeared completely on a simple solo trip that had led him straight through the Bermuda Triangle. And then, in 1918, a huge US Navy ship called the Cyclops disappeared without ever sending a single SOS. In those days, an SOS signal would be sent in the Morse code whenever a ship or boat was in trouble on the seas. The Cyclops had a radio. The crew could have called for help. Why didn't they? There were 309 men on board. All vanished. It was the largest Navy ship ever lost without a trace. It had been sailing from the Barbados in the West Indies toward Chesapeake Bay in the route it took right through the Bermuda Triangle. The Cyclops wasn't the last ship to run into strange troubles in those dangerous waters. Only a few years later, another ghost ship was found adrift. And this time, the story was filled with so many twists and turns, it could have been a spy movie.